All right, today we're going to decode a number that you see everywhere in finance, the bond yield. And trust me, it is so much more than just a percentage. It's actually a story about a company's health, its industry, and yeah, even some of its secrets. So, what exactly is that story?
Well, it all kicks off with a really simple but kind of confusing question. Let's say you see a bond from some huge, stable company offering maybe a 3% return, but then, right next to it, some smaller company's offering 8%. So what gives? Why would anyone ever pick the lower number? That is the exact mystery we are solving today. And spoiler alert, the answer is all about risk.
So, to really crack this open, we have to start at the very beginning and figure out what a yield rate even is. Because it's not just a number. You gotta think of it more like a language.
And here is the single most important translation you need to know. A bond's yield is a direct reflection of its total risk. The higher that yield, the riskier investors think it is. It's not really about profit, it's about being compensated for taking a bigger gamble.
And here's the cool part. We can break down this whole risk story with one super simple formula. Every single bond yield you ever see is made of just two things, a starting point called the risk-free rate, plus this extra layer on top called the risk premium. That's it. This formula, this is going to be our roadmap for the next few minutes.
So let's break this down. We're going to start with that first piece of the puzzle, the foundation that everything else gets built on top of, the risk-free rate.
Just think of the risk-free rate as the absolute rock-bottom baseline. It's the return you'd get on an investment that has practically zero chance of going bust, you know, like a government bond. It's the solid ground that every other investment gets measured against.
Okay, now for the really interesting part. If the risk-free rate is our baseline, the risk premium is all the extra juice that investors demand for daring to take a risk on one specific company. This is where the company's unique story comes into play.
And this premium comes in two main flavors. First, you've got business risk. This is the stuff that affects the entire industry, you know, new regulations, rising costs, things like that. Then you've got financial risk. This one is totally unique to the company itself. It's all about its own choices, and specifically, how much debt it's taken on.
And here's why that's so important. A company that has very little debt, what we'd call low leverage, is really only dealing with that general industry risk. But a company that's borrowed a ton of money to grow, whoa, it has a much higher financial risk, and you better believe investors are going to demand a bigger premium for that.
Okay, enough with the theory. Let's make this feel real. We're going to apply our formula to two totally different companies and see exactly how their stories and their yields are put together.
So, for our little example here, let's just say the market's risk-free rate, our foundation, remember, is sitting at 4.5%. This is the starting line for every company's bond, no matter who they are.
And wow, this chart just says it all, doesn't it? Everybody starts at that 4.5% base. Now, for a huge, stable company like Coca-Cola with very little debt, the risk premium is tiny, just a little sliver, maybe 0.4%, bringing their total to 4.9%. But now look at a real estate company that's loaded up with big loans. Its risk premium is massive, maybe 3.5%, all because of that financial risk. You add that to the same 4.5% base, and its yield skyrockets to 8%. See? Same foundation, completely different stories stacked on top.
Which brings us to the final piece of this puzzle. You've probably heard in the news something like bond yields are rising across the market. So why do they all seem to move up and down together?
It's really just a simple domino effect. When the central bank raises the main interest rate, our risk-free rate, that foundation, has to go up with it. And because that rate is the starting point for every single bond, the total yield for all of them gets pushed up automatically, even if the companies themselves haven't gotten any riskier.
You know, the easiest way to picture this is to think of a building. The risk-free rate is the concrete foundation. Each company's risk premium is a different floor stacked on top. If the ground itself suddenly rises by a foot, the entire building, every single floor, goes up with it. It has to.
So, what's the big takeaway here? A bond's yield is not just some random number on a screen. It's a story. It's a story written in numbers that tells you about the entire market, the risks of an industry, and the specific choices a single company made.
So, from now on, when you see a bond yield, you're not just going to see a percentage. You're going to see the story behind it. You'll know exactly what question to ask. What story of risk is this bond trying to tell me? And now, you know how to read the answer.